Greetings, Southwest local schools, parents and guardians and community members. John Hamstra, superintendent here, just to talk quickly about our fourth quarter wrap up as we do each year, coming to a close quickly as we get ready to celebrate the 143rd graduating class from Harrison High School tonight. It'll take place right here in the Activity Center starting at 7:30 p.m. This is our last graduating class of under 300 students in the foreseeable future. Our largest graduating class coming up is actually our first graders, who are over 400 kids for perspective. Tonight we'll have over 245 graduates walk across the stage, which we're extremely excited about. All 600 plus of our Southwest Local School employees pushed hard this school year to live our mission, which is academic and social growth for all students every single day. And when we talk academic growth, we're talking about 1.5 years growth for each kid in all four core subject areas. One way that we gauge that is through our AIMS web testing for our little guys in grades K through 3, and again with MAP testing in grades 1 through 10. You can find the results of those reports in your child's Abre account, so please make sure you check that. I will say on the front end that in most every grade that did take place as a whole. There are some students that didn't meet that criteria, but again, it's our absolute goal each and every year to make that happen. On the social side this school year, our goal was to see 100% of our kids involved in extracurriculars, and we came up just short of that with 88.9% of our kids participating in one of the 55 clubs that we offer, or 26 varsity sports, as well as our visual and performing arts endeavors. When you talk 88.9% of our kids, we're talking over 4,000 of our 4,500 students taking part in at least one extracurricular, which is impressive. The struggle is getting that last 500, that group of 500 kids plugged in, and that's going to be our goal this summer, is to create offerings that work for those guys. But we're going to need your help as parents to push your kids also to get involved in the fall and next school year. Please make sure you visit our district websites to check and see what's out there, what clubs are available, even for our kindergartners, all the way up through seniors. Speaking of extracurriculars, quick shout out to our athletic department for earning the All Sports Trophy once again, back-to-back years, as well as our back-to-back state team champions for girls wrestling. Some areas to keep in mind as we head into the summer. Please make sure you work to keep your child in a routine this summer. I think giving them a week off obviously is more than okay, but once we hit June 5, to have a routine established is extremely important. And when I say routine, I'm talking reading for 30 minutes a day, and then finding some type of summer bridge work, and you can find them online pretty easily, and they're pretty inexpensive actually, to do at least 15 minutes of math work each day. After that, I would send them outside. Limit the screen time as much as possible. Get them playing with friends. Get them outside. Get them plugged into a summer camp or two or three. We offer several here at the school. Please check our website again for those different opportunities. But get them involved. Get them going to bed at a decent hour every night and up in the morning at a decent hour. And really be leery of diet and exercise. Those pieces are all key and will help us out a tremendous amount come fall time. Mark your calendars for several key and important dates this coming fall. Two that I'm going to throw out there. First is August 8th, which is our State of the Schools, which will happen at 7 p.m. here at the Activity Center. And then the next important date is our Town Hall number 4, which will be at the Junior High on September 14th, starting at 6 p.m. Both events provide a major update of where our schools stand with regards to academic performance, enrollment, future construction needs or concerns, and a time to basically sound off on what you feel is going well and what you feel needs improved. Also, another key piece this early this summer will be surveys that will get pushed out through our principals. One will speak to kind of your child's experience at their individual school, how things went from a climate standpoint, from a customer service standpoint, from an academic standpoint. And the second survey link will be more district oriented on what you would like to see changed here at Southwest Local Schools. Obviously, our schools are your schools, and our schools are as strong as the community that supports them. So please be on the lookout for those two survey links. And like I said, they will come out here right towards the end of school, if not a couple days after kids are dismissed. Last but not least, parents, we need you to get involved in our schools as well. We talk about kids 100% involvement. We would love to see more of our parents step up and join the different booster organizations, the PTO. It's not a lot of work, especially if you have lots of people doing the lifting. Right now, our numbers are dropping in those areas, and that is somewhat concerning. I think people just kind of look and say, hey, other people will take care of it. We need you to step up and get involved and to help out your schools. Even if it's just one day a month, that would be extraordinary and something that would help big time down the road. So please think of ways that you could get involved as a parent this coming fall. We're going to leave you with some incredible pictures from this school year, some memories that kind of are near and dear to our hearts. Have an awesome summer, and we will see you this coming fall. Make some memories.
Get down tonight, 'cause it's always a good time. Slept in all my clothes like I didn't care. Hopped into a cab, take me anywhere.